That's why I Thank you. and healing the sick. Yeah. And many was delivered from all manner of sickness.
Yeah.
Because they believed Christ and they walked in his teaching. And that's how we got our nickname Christian. They could have called us Jesus X, or they could have called us Lordites. But we were named Christians, derived from the word Christ, which means the anointed of God. I said, we should be anointed of God. We should have that same power. The power that Jesus Christ had, that he gave to his disciples, and goes back in the early church. When someone has come up and possessed with the demon, we should be able to cast it out. Sickness should not reign in our bodies. We should have healing. We should not have impression over the devil. Because the devil belongs under our feet. I said, we need to not get caught up with the spirit of this age. But let every man be alive, and let what God said be true.
Yes.
I think, and I praise God for even these little scattered remarks. But one thing we must always do is to be spiritually minded.
Yes.
Because our adversary, the devil, is not here.
Yes.
And he is real.
Yes.
And if you don't believe it, get your guards down and don't read your word.
Yes.
Meditate like you're supposed to meditate.
Yes.
And you will find out the true man.
Yes.
You know, we so holy sometimes that we just acknowledge the fact that he can't do nothing to us. Oh, we have the Holy Ghost, this is true. But is our Holy Ghost working the right way it's supposed to be working? Or is it just lying and saying, has it lost fellowship with God? Are we just walking around physically? Eternal death. You can be alive, but yet you can be dead. Jesus Christ is tired of these so-called deaf Christians because they need to renew themselves unto Christ.
Yes.
They need to know what the word Christian is.
Yes.
Not just coming to church every Sunday.
No.
Not just singing in the choir.
No.
Not just sitting in those pews.
No.
But we need to know who Christ is.
Yes.
And what he is in our life.
Yes.
And in our spirit, right with him.
Yes.
Ephesians 1:50 said, know who you are in Christ.
Yes.
We have to examine ourselves.
Yes.
And we have to see if we are held up to what Christ wants us to be held up to. And if we're not, tonight is, we can come right to this altar.
Yes.
And then we have so many shamed Christians. They're scared to come to the altar because someone else might talk about it. But if we have a spirit of love, we won't open our mouth. When we see our brother hurting, they can come right to the altar. And they don't need to be ashamed. Jesus Christ said, if you be ashamed of me, I'm going to be ashamed of you in heaven. So if we have a problem, don't be scared to get out of your chair and come up here. Or out of your seat and come up here for prayer. That's not what God wants. He wants to heal you.
Yes.
He wants deliverance of you.
Yes.
But you must believe and you must have faith that you can do that. Be not caught up with the spirit of this age. Young folks, when you go to school, be not caught up with that spirit. If you have to just sit by yourself, sit by yourself. If you have to encourage yourself, just do as they do encourage yourself.
Yes.
Talk to yourself. Read yourself. Get tapes and play them. So we listen to songs too many times. Sometimes we need to get some preaching tapes and out of the set. And we need to sit under the word day and night.
Yeah.
On my way to work, I got word in. On my way home, I got word in.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, because these are troublesome times. I do not want to be caught up in the spirit of the day.
Right.
I made my own tape. I got scriptures on my tape that I listen to. We're all going to work. I thank and I praise God because he's given me a mind just to stay under the word. Just stay under the word. We don't need to be caught up with the spirit of this age. And we do not need to be falling away with these spirits out here because they can